This is WKTV Journal. The City of Kentwood recently announced that it's partnered with Kent County to help residents stay connected with free public wireless internet access, now available at 13 Kentwood locations, including at city parks. With us today is Mayor Stephen Kepley to talk about that unique effort, as well as the Kentwood Park Stewardship Program and the launch of the city's second Little Food Pantry. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
So I've been reading that forward-thinking cities across the nation, across the world, are looking at internet access for their communities as almost an infrastructure along the lines of water and power. How important do you see having that sort of access for the community is for the present and the future of the city of Kentwood?
It's mandatory if we want to be successful, if we want to succeed as a community. If I've said it once, I've said it 100 times. What makes a city strong is a strong business community. So you have to have internet access for our businesses to be able to do what they need to do and survive. But you know, definitely during the pandemic, we said that it extends beyond our businesses, and that is to our residents. Because of the pandemic, with schools not having in-person classes, you know, how are our students to learn? Through the internet. You know, fortunately, the city of Kentwood has quite a few providers of internet. So it's not really that we need internet coverage as a city like they might have outside of this urban area. It's more of, are they able to afford it? And mm-hmm. So the city of Kentwood has gotten involved and partnered with the county to provide Wi-Fi internet access throughout the city that's free to our residents.
Okay. As I understand it, this as a joint venture, or at least a co-venture with Kent County. Tell us a little bit about how this venture came about, where the funding comes from, both for infrastructure and then for the long-term operation of this, please.
Right. So because of the pandemic, the federal government has provided funds. It's called CARES funds, to be distributed through the states and through the county. And so one of the county goals was to help with Wi-Fi access for the Kent County residents. So the city of Kentwood has partnered with Kent County. There was about $60,000 that was available to the city of Kentwood to put up about 15 hotspots in 13 different locations, 11 parks, so that our residents, if they weren't able to afford a Wi-Fi, could come and get online for their students or for their own work.
Right. The selection of the city campus, makes sense to me. The idea of including it in parks. Is that something that the city has seen elsewhere? Is that something that the city leader said, maybe that's a good idea?
Well, it's really a practical decision. If you think about, we have a large city, and we are placing these things on public property. And so we're looking at what do we own. And the other thing is we need electricity and power. So we have parks, we're responsible for the parks, they are public domain, and we have access, easements, and we also have electrical power. And a lot of them have shelters in different places where, if need be, they can go and sit under a shelter or shade to be able to jump online. So it's really a practical matter of location and power.
Very good. So the Wi-Fi hotspots are not the only new project in the city. I understand there's a couple of other new things coming online or already online. Catch us up a little bit on the new Kentwood Park Stewardship Program. And also, I understand the city has opened the second Little Food Bank. Please right. Tell us about those efforts.
Well, I tell you, the first with the Kentwood Stewardship Program really was outcome of COVID, believe it or not. So myself and my wife, because of COVID, and you couldn't really help our restaurants because they were closed, and what do you do? We walked. We walked our parks and our trails, and we went outside, walking on different parks and trails outside the city of Kentwood. It was really in March and April when the pandemic started that we were at one of our neighboring parks and saw this really a hideous vine that had taken over a large area of forest. And it was a big concern because I'd seen the same type of vine in our parks. And so we ended up getting partnering with the Kent County agency on invasive vines mm-hmm. and species. Mm-hmm. And they really helped us learn about what it is. And when we saw the extent of what we need to do for our parks, we knew that we couldn't do it on our own. We did not have enough staff or dollars to really take care of this issue, that we needed help from our community. And as you well know, on our
community effort.
It's a community effort. We needed the community to join to help us to be able to really preserve trees. And you know, we really want to preserve the tree canopy, and that means preserving what we have and plant additional trees also.
Right.
So that's how it started.
This is another example, I would think, that of getting the community, not only community effort, but the community buy-in on what the city is doing. I mean, these parks, people have their favorite park, people have their favorite trail. Okay, you know, you're part of the, you're part of the group now that's helping to protect this. That citizen buy-in, I assume, is important.
Right, it is, and also training. The Kent County Conservation District is who trained us, and we provided educational opportunities throughout the week at various locations where our residents did come and learn, and really get the passion for why are we doing this. And I encourage people to go to other parks that that right now are outside the city that have been overwhelmed, so that if we don't do this, that's what we should expect, and it's not a good outcome. We really need to jump on this and take care of business.
Very good. So the last thing we wanted to talk a little about is the city's little food pantry has
right.
been a very successful effort. You know, the city is rightfully proud of that system. We've opened a second one now. Tell
right.
us about the second one, and also I guess the continuing need for the community.
Right. So the second little food pantry has been opened up at our library.
Mm-hmm.
So we have one, of course, at the Parks and Rec facility on 48th Street, and then sort of in the middle of our city at the library. Well, definitely we have people that need food, and consistently, not just this season, but probably throughout the duration. And so it's really a honor system. You can come and you can take what you need, but you also are encouraged to drop off. And I'll tell you, it really is, again, a community effort, because you have all sorts of organizations and faith-based organizations that have really gathered around our little food pantries to make it successful and work.
Very good. Well, we want to thank you very much for coming in, talking with us a little bit about these new projects that make Kentwood just a little better place to live and do business, as we've talked about. Thank you very much for your time, sir.
Thank you for having me.
Very good. Stay with us. In Focus, we'll be back shortly.
Hi, this is Tom from WKTV Journal, encouraging you to subscribe to the WKTV Journal YouTube page right there, and also click the notification bell right there every time you want to be notified about a new community event happening with your community news source, the WKTV Journal.